Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss the following question, which says that prove that sec of tan inverse of cosec of cot inverse of 1 by x is equal to square root of 2x square plus 1 by x. Let us proceed with the solution. We are given the expression sec of tan inverse of cosec of cot inverse of 1 by x. Here, let theta be equal to cot inverse of 1 by x, which implies that cot of theta is equal to 1 upon x. In a triangle ABC, if theta is the angle between the lines AC and CB, then cot of angle theta is given by base upon perpendicular, that is BC upon AB, which is equal to 1 upon x. Now, if base BC is given by 1 and perpendicular AB is given by x, then we can find the hypotenuse AC by using the Pythagoras theorem. So, by Pythagoras theorem, we have hypotenuse AC is equal to square root of square of the perpendicular AB plus square of the base BC, which is equal to square root of x square plus 1 square, that is 1. Now we know that cosec of angle theta is given by hypotenuse by perpendicular, that is AC upon AB, which is given by square root of x square plus 1 by x. Therefore, we have cosec of angle theta is equal to square root of x square plus 1 by x, which implies that theta is given by cosec inverse of square root of x square plus 1 by x. We have assumed the value of theta as cot inverse of 1 by x, and theta is equal to cosec inverse of square root of x square plus 1 by x. Therefore, we can say that cot inverse of 1 by x is equal to cosec inverse of square root of x square plus 1 by x. Therefore, the expression cosec of cot inverse of 1 by x becomes cosec of cosec inverse of square root of x square plus 1 by x, which is equal to square root of x square plus 1 by x. Now, putting the value of cosec of cot inverse of 1 by x as square root of x square plus 1 upon x, in the given expression we get sec of tan inverse of cosec of cot inverse of 1 by x is square root of x square plus 1 by x. Now, let phi be equal to tan inverse of square root of x square plus 1 by x, which implies that tan of phi is equal to square root of x square plus 1 by x. Now, in a triangle PQR, if phi is the angle between the lines PR and RQ, then tan of angle phi is given by perpendicular upon base, that is PQ upon RQ, which is given by square root of x square plus 1 by x. If perpendicular PQ is given by square root of x square plus 1 and base RQ is given by x, then we can find the value of the hypotenuse PR by using the Pythagoras theorem. By Pythagoras theorem, we have hypotenuse PR is equal to square root of square of the perpendicular PQ plus square of the base RQ, which is equal to square root of PQ square, that is square root of x square plus 1 the whole square, which is equal to x square plus 1 plus RQ square, that is x square, which is equal to square root of 2x square plus 1. So hypotenuse PR is equal to square root of 2x square plus 1. Now we know that sec of angle phi is given by hypotenuse by base, that is RP upon RQ, which is equal to square root of 2x square plus 1 by x. Therefore, sec of angle phi is equal to square root of 2x square plus 1 by x, which implies that phi is equal to sec inverse of square root of 2x square plus 1 upon x. Now, as we have assumed the value of phi as tan inverse of square root of x square plus 1 by x, and phi is also equal to sec inverse of square root of 2x square plus 1 by x, this implies that tan inverse of square root of x square plus 1 by x is equal to sec inverse of square root of 2x square plus 1 by x. Therefore, the expression sec of tan inverse of square root of x square plus 1 by x can be written as sec of sec inverse of square root of 2x square plus 1 by x, which is equal to square root of 2x square plus 1 by x. Hence prove the result, that is sec of tan inverse of cosec of cot inverse of 1 by x is equal to square root of 2x square plus 1 by x. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.